Hi there, and welcome to Conestoga College's virtual fair. My name is Professor Kevin Bell, and I teach and coordinate the automotive programs at Conestoga College's Guelph campus, which is where our motive power programs take place. I'd like to take a few minutes and take you through both the fundamentals program and the technician program, and just explain the difference between the two programs. So if we have a look, our motive power fundamentals and our motive power technicians program, these ones are both automotive service programs. So we're looking at students that are interested in getting into a career or getting into the field of automotive repair and automotive service. Our Motive Power Fundamentals program is a one-year program, which happens over two semesters and will qualify the student for an Ontario College Certificate upon graduation. So this is designed for someone that wants to get into the field, wants to get into the career of automotive repair, service, and maintenance. Semester one of the program is going to introduce the students to some foundational lessons in basic automotive construction, automotive operation, automotive repair, as well as some electrical circuits, business practices, and routine vehicle maintenance. Obviously, some workplace safety is going to be in there as well. Semester two is going to introduce the student to level one apprenticeship material. This is what qualifies both the student and the program as having a level one apprenticeship equivalency once they have successfully graduated the program. So there's the subjects that we have a look at in both one in semester one as well as semester two within the program. If we want more details on those subjects or you want a few more in-depth answers, we can follow the link and that'll take us to Conestoga College's webpage. And just make sure that we're looking at the Motive Power Fundamentals Automotive Repair Program, because there are several different Motive Power Fundamentals programs. Not all of them are obviously automotive related. If we scroll down the page, about halfway down the page, we'll find a section that says course details, and we can elaborate on that. And then each one of these will go into a little more detail as to exactly what's being taught in that subject area and how many hours are going to be delivered in that subject area. So that's the one-year program. The two-year program is a motive power technician program, and it takes place obviously over four semesters. This is going to qualify the student with an Ontario College diploma once they graduate the program. So still designed for the student that wants to get into the automotive industry, but maybe wants to continue to develop their skills at a slightly higher level in the second year of the program, as well as learn some more about business ownership and business knowledge. So semester one and semester two are the same as the one-year program. Where the change takes place is semester three. So in the second year of the program, the student begins to receive level two apprenticeship material, which is what's going to qualify them as having a level two apprenticeship equivalency when they graduated the program. The last semester of the program, they'll finish off their level two subjects and then be exposed to advanced diagnostics in fuel injection, electrical systems, and hybrid electric vehicles. So this program just goes into a little more detail, and you can absolutely migrate from the one-year program into the two-year program should you choose at the end of year number one. So there's the first semester subjects, exactly the same as the one-year program. When we move into the second year, we then get exposed to air conditioning systems, engine failure analysis, electric hybrids, parts management, and a couple of other subjects. Same as before, if we want to know some detailed information, we can just follow that link. That'll take us to the Motive Power Technician Automotive Service. And about halfway down that page, again, we'll see course details, and those course details will expand out. There's our first semester and second semester, followed by the third semester and the fourth semester subject areas. And any of those can be clicked on and they will elaborate and expand on those particular subject areas. Program requirements, there are some mandatory requirements, Conestoga crested coveralls, they meet certain safety standards so they can be used in the shop, they can be used in the welding department. CSA approved safety shoes and CSA approved safety glasses, obviously required in all shop environments. Recommended equipment, a laptop or a computer obviously would be beneficial for taking class notes, research assignments. The college has several computer labs that you're welcome to use, but they may not necessarily meet your time frame or may not be easy to access on your time or on your hours. Basic hand tools, again, would be suggested. The college has a fairly well-outfitted shop with lots of hand tools, lots of mechanical tools. However, if you choose to bring your own tools in, like a new digital multimeter, and you want a little bit of experience using it, then yes, we encourage the students to bring some of their own tools in. Your own car would be beneficial, not mandatory, obviously. The college has cars for you to work on. However, if you own your own vehicle and you want to do some basic maintenance, you want to learn a little more about it, this is a great opportunity. In semester one of both programs, you'll have over 100 shop hours to work on the car, do maintenance, understand how certain things function, and basic requirements of that vehicle. Career opportunities within the program. The end goal, obviously, would be a licensed 310S automotive service technician. That's one possibility. You may decide to get into a service advisor or a parts advisor role, aftermarket accessory specialist. So you're working for an aftermarket or a performance parts manufacturer in the retail sales. Diagnostic specialist, maybe you've taken the two-year program and you've got advanced diagnostic skills and you decide to get into fuel injection diagnostics, electrical diagnostics, as well as drivability. Or you may decide to become a shop owner or a service manager in a dealership. So there's lots of possibilities for careers once you've graduated this program. We'll have a quick look inside our shops virtually, obviously. So we'll have a start by looking at one of the automotive shops that we have in our Guelph campus. So we'll just do a quick scan around here. We can do a 360-degree view and have a good idea of how the shops are outfitted. Four-post alignment hoists, two-post hoists, plus a whole series of models that the college has that the students are obviously able to work on. Next shop we'll have a look at is our engine shop or our machine shop. So the engine shop or the machine shop, both in level one and level two, the students will be in here working on engine blocks, disassembling and reassembling, cylinder heads, valves, camshafts, and again, understanding what goes on in the top end of the engine as well as the bottom end of the engine. Next shop we'll have a look at is our advanced fuel shop or our alternative fuel shop. This is where most of the hybrid lessons are going to take place. This shop also has a classroom built into it, so you may find that you're scheduled to be in here for your theory classes, and then during the theory classes, you can migrate into the shop and have a tackle some of the projects or some of the tasks inside the shop. Benefits of the program, graduating with level one or level two provincial apprenticeship equivalency, again, depending on whether you're in the one-year or the two-year program. Provides a pathway into traditional apprenticeship once you've completed the program. With a college certificate or a college education behind you, there'll be less competition in the workforce. Easier to apply for a job and stand a better chance of getting that job. College education typically results in higher starting wages, and it shortens up the apprenticeship time a little bit. So if you're spending 2 years in the college on a two-year program, another couple of years in the trade, and you're on your way to writing your certificate of qualification. If you still have any questions or if there's anything I haven't answered for you, please feel free to contact either myself or Abby. We'll be happy to answer any questions you have. And if I can't answer the questions, then I can certainly point you in the direction of someone that can. So on behalf of Conestoga College, I'd like to thank you for coming out. Thank you for enjoying the virtual fair and hope to see you in the classrooms come September. Have a great day.